Maybe shortly introduce yourself before we get started.
Martin, good morning to all of you. My name is Dhruv Thakur. I am head legal compliance Marbudo India. I welcome you all at this webinar where we are going to discuss about product registrations with BIS. I will take your questions, Martin, one by one. Before that, as you said, that I would like to share background information so that the spectators or audience will be more familiar with the discussion we are doing here. We all know about World Trade Organization. One of the objectives of World Trade Organization is to have a flow of trade among member countries as smooth and predictable as possible, and to remove unreasonable restrictions in trade. However, technical barriers to trade, such as regulations, process of registrations, standards, are not considered unreasonable restrictions, and many of the member countries have their own technical regulations. India also has its own technical regulations, and these technical regulations are issued in the form of quality control order, we say QCO, and then QCO can be issued either by concerned ministries of government of India, or we have very few regulatory bodies set up by government. Like for food product, we have different regulatory body, we say FSSAI. For medical products, drugs, we have CDSCO. BEE is for product consuming energy, etc. So these quality control order, I'll show you a copy of quality control order. Quality control order specify that the certain product requires registration with Bureau of Indian Standard. And so far as power to government to issue these regulations are given by Bureau of Indian Standard Act, Section 16 of Act empowers government to issue technical regulations for the purpose of health of the people, safety of environment, public interest, national security. So we have quality control order, and because of requirement of registration mentioned in quality control order, the manufacturers in India needs to get registered their product with BIS, and foreign manufacturers who would like to export their products into India, they also need to get registration with Bureau of Indian Standard.
And as you were because these BIS, these technical regulations, they're on the increase, right? Why is it relevant and urgent that the audience that is listening today, why do they need to know about this? Because the number of technical regulations are on the rise. We heard just from Mr. Alok Kesari. I think you... Can you show some numbers?
I understood your question, Martin. So I have compiled few technical regulations applicable for product registration with BIS to show you here. You can see here the year 2020, the list of regulations are issued in the year 2020 and in the month of January 2021. Almost 16-18 quality control orders have been issued during this period. And for some of the product, you can see here, for example, footwear, the standard came in the month of September 1st, then October, December. So when new standard comes, new quality control order comes, either a new product is introduced, like in the last line you can see, toys, which came in the February 2020. Before that, there was no registration requirement with BIS of any toys. But after this quality control orders came into picture, we need to go for registration. For some of the product, there is an addition of new products. Like in steel, nowadays there are 150 categories of steels which need BIS registration. Initially, there were very few. So by new order, either new categories are created for registration requirement, or in the existing category, new products are added by government.
Mm. So new categories are coming on, new products are coming on basically every month. So it's really something that the companies need to keep an eye on. What happens when your product is that when there's an order issued for your product that you need to go for registration? What does a company have to do? What's the process?
Okay, before I come on the process, I would like to show you an example how a quality control orders look like. Okay. In the right hand side of the screen, you can see a quality control order. This is issued by Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. Mm-hmm. And date of publication of order is 16th June 2020. So the date of publication of quality control order is different from the of implementation, because industry and manufacturer needs certain time to get their product registered with BIS. So mm-hmm. You can see the highlighted part that it shall come into force on 181st day from the date of its publication in official gazette. Generally, 6 month time is given by quality control order to get the product registration done. And if you see here in the last part of this order, there is a table, the name of product is mentioned. The goods or articles column, you can see pyridine. Pyridine is a chemical. So after this regulation came into picture, pyridine is not a product which can be sold in India without registration with Bureau of Indian Standard. And every time a product is mentioned in the quality control order, the related Indian standard which are applicable with respect to that product is also mentioned. You can see here IS Indian Standard 8058 is the relevant standard which is required to be complied in order to get the product registered pyridine with Bureau of Indian Standard.
So when a company was selling this product in the January 2020, they could just sell it in India without any regulations. Then on the 16th of June, there's this order being issued that within 181 days, you can only sell it when you have when you're registered. When you have the product is registered, so that's if you don't comply with this, the whole sales for this product in India will stop. So everybody has to go through this process. Then, can you say something about that?
Yes. So before I come on the process of registrations, I would like to share some more information. Regarding registration process with BIS, there are two categories of product. One is not only category of products, category of registrations, I would say. In the left side, you can see there is a different logo. In the right hand side, there is a different logo. So actually, there are two category of products which needs registration, and there are different process of registration, different timeline, different officers or department involved in that. So for category CRS, compulsory registration scheme, the products which are covered under this category are information technology and electronics item. And it also covers solar goods. So there are 76 categories of products which covered under this CRS registration scheme of BIS. And just to show you a glimpse of a product, I have mentioned a few of the examples. Laptop, tablets, LCD, LED scanners, mobile phones, LED lamps, these are the products which are covered under this CRS category. Once we apply for registration, if registration is granted, the license is initially granted for 2 years. Thereafter, it can be applied for renewal for another 2 to 5 years. And after expiry of this 2 to 5 years, we can reapply for renewal. In the right-hand category, you can say there are 344 categories of products which needs this ISI mark license from BIS. So this ISI mark scheme category is more diversified in comparison to the CRS category, and products which are covered here may be from cement, electrical steel, electrical goods, foods, cylinder, steel, fertilizers, cables, AC, wine, footwear, many categories of products. I will show you the slide where the name of these 344 categories of products are mentioned group wise. And once a license is granted, this is for valid for 1 year, which can be renewed another for 1 to 5 years, and we can again apply for renewal here. So these are the product category of 344 items which are covered under ISI mark scheme. You can see in the left hand side, steel and iron products, which is having biggest category, 150 products are covered under this. And second biggest is chemicals and fertilizers, the last row in the first column, 33 products. And then footwear, 27. Some of the product only having one category. But these are the categories of products or items which needs BIS registration under ISI category.
That is, of course, at this moment, because it's growing basically every month, this list, right?
Yes, this list I have taken, this is just 1 week old. And we keep eye on that. And as I said, or as Mr. Kesari also explained, the list is not static. This is dynamic. Addition, generally no deletion, only additions are going on in the list. So after 1 month or after 6 months, you will see there are more items here, maybe more categories of the product here.
Okay, understood.
Yeah. So I saw this slide to show to explain the product registration with regard to CRS, that is electronics and IT products. Hmm. There are basically three stages of registration. Under first stage, we create a login ID and password by providing certain informations regarding product, regarding applicant, regarding the business license, manufacturers, all informations. And after creating a login ID and password, we generate test request letter. This is very important because the products which are covered under BIS registration, import is not allowed and custom will stop the product. But once we have this test request letter and we provide this to custom, custom allow this to understand that this is not for commercial activity, this is for testing purpose. So we import the samples into India. And samples are required to be tested in India by approved lab by BIS. We pay testing charges to a laboratory, and the report is directly provided to BIS by the laboratory. After that, we come on the application part, which needs various informations regarding the product, regarding the manufacturer, regarding their management, technical management, top management, the contact, the authorized person from the manufacturer side, who will sign the document. We also need authorized Indian representative from India who will represent that foreign manufacturer. And we nominate that AIR, authorized Indian representative. Once we complete this part and documents are available with us, report is also available, then we pay application fee to BIS, generate Form 6, and submit all documents report to them for scrutinization. BIS scrutinize all the documents, raise query. Once we reply the query, they are satisfied, then the license is granted. In the last column of this page, you can see so far for this IT and electronics category of product, 15,841 cases are registered, which includes Indian as well as foreign manufacturers and products. And there are 61 countries covered under this. It means manufacturers of 61 countries applied for these registrations here. And the biggest category is sales and batteries, having 2,644 number of registrations. And applications which are filed with BIS, but not license have not been granted, there are 926 categories. And this data is just 1 week old. So this is all about registration for electronics and IT related product. The whole process of registration takes approximately 2 to 3 months of time for this category. Mm-hmm. This is a smaller period considering this ISI mark registration.
And Drew, before you go into this, only the manufacturer can apply for these certifications, right? Or whose task is this? Who should do this?
So as this is clear, this is a quality certification of the product, and quality can be ensured by the manufacturer only. So only manufacturer is required to apply here, and application from manufacturer will only be entertained by BIS. So if application is filed by importer, distributor, or group company, or any intermediaries, that will be rejected, because the purpose of this registration is quality certification.
Okay, that's clear.
Yeah. You want me to share a brief process regarding this ISI mark registration?
Yes, please do. Please do, because we are going to be a bit over time anyway. So people who have to leave, we say goodbye in a few minutes. But otherwise, we just continue for just a little bit, and you can watch it back the recording.
Okay, so I will be very brief. For all foreign manufacturers, BIS has a centralized division in Delhi only. We say FMCD. So all applications are filed only in Delhi. Otherwise, BIS has various regional offices and branch offices. But for our purpose, only office FMCD department of BIS Delhi is concerned. We file application for registration there. You already asked who can be applicant. I replied. So we escape this slide and come next one. So for ISI mark registration, this is a bigger process comparing this CRS registration. So there are three stages of that. First is documentation. This is, I would say, exhaustive documentation regarding product, manufacturer, application, equipment used in production process, equipment used in test laboratories. Everything is required to be submitted to BIS as per the standard requirement. Once we file the application, we also ensure that there is Indian representative, because Indian representative is required to countersign document, and there is a physical submission of document requirement with BIS. Once we file the documents, as per our experience, it takes approximately 1 month time. When we discuss with manufacturer very collaboratively, we prepare documents in 1 month or 1.5 month, and then we file documents with BIS. BIS scrutinize that. There is query on that. Once documents are acceptable to BIS, then they announce the person or their senior officer who needs to visit the place of manufacturer to verify the document submitted, and to also see the process to get the samples tested in front of him in the laboratory of the manufacturer. And also samples are sealed, sent to India for testing by Indian laboratory approved by BIS. So once the report of laboratory is submitted to BIS, and the officer visiting premises of manufacturing facilities, he also prepares his report, submit to BIS. BIS scrutinize everything, and then the license is granted. And the whole process of this registration takes approximately 6 to 8 months of time, depending upon the support provided by the manufacturer, and depending upon the, you know, this long queue with BIS.
So, and what are approximately the costs? Can you say something in general about this, or does it depend on the product as well?
I can share you general cost structure, but obviously there is slight variations depending upon product to product, but overall idea can be taken. So application filing cost is, I mean, fees is very small amount, $15 to $20. And once the BIS officer is nominated by BIS, the BIS officer is supposed to visit the place of manufacturer, as I already said. Entire expenses for his visa, for his travel to and fro, staying there, it takes approximately 2 to 3 working days to cover one application by the BIS officer there, in terms of verifying and doing his part of work. we also have to pay to BIS approximately 1,000 euro dollar. That will be inspection charges and visiting charges for the officer there.
Mm-hmm.
In addition to that, we have approximately 800 to 1,000 US dollar as testing charges by the laboratory, because testing is a must during the process.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the expenses. And once the license is granted, there is a requirement of performance being guarantee submitted to the BIS by the manufacturer, and the amount is 10,000 US dollar. So this 10,000 US dollar is not required to be deposited with BIS, but the banker of manufacturer can give a bank guarantee to BIS. So these mm-hmm. are the expenses in a nutshell for product registration with respect to this ISI registration.
Mm-hmm. And so are there any alternative options? I heard something about the no objection certificate. Is this a way to avoid having to go through this this process?
Actually, this is not an alternate solution. This is alternate, I would say, this is one of the additional process, and this is required to be applied in a case where product registration is not required to be done by manufacturer. As I mm-hmm. said in the beginning, that for every specific product named in the quality control order, specific registrations are also mentioned. Standards are mentioned. So manufacturer is required to comply the terms and conditions of the standard. And if manufacturer fails to comply the terms and conditions, in the terms and conditions, we have many things. We have chemical compositions, mechanical properties, scope, and everything. So if there is a deviation at any part, that manufacturer is not able to suppose meet the chemical composition for all the product, then license will not be granted. But in that case, manufacturer has the option to apply with BIS saying that my product is not prepared or made or manufactured as per the standard of BIS. This is a proprietary product, or this is based on any other international standard. So I request you to grant no objection certificate for that. Mm-hmm. So in that case, the concerned ministry, for steel ministry, for other ministry, for other product, we have concerned ministry. So they can consider the application and may grant no objection certificate. So, but this is not an alternate solution, but this is a solution in a case where manufacturer is not able to meet with product registration requirement. But this is, I would say, it depends upon the nature of product, it depends upon the compliance, or it depends upon the understanding of the authority, whether NOCs would be granted or not granted.
Mm. I get quite a number of questions also from the listeners about, of course, about their products. Someone is asking, would a fire truck be registered under CRS or under ISI? Someone else is asking, is BIS needed for agricultural machinery or parts for the production of these machines? In general, if companies want to know, is my product or parts of my product, is registration needed? Can you help? Can your team help with this?
Yes, we can help that. But the product you have mentioned at this moment, this fire truck or agricultural machineries, they are out of purview of BIS registration. But anybody can, okay, on the screen you can see there is a link of Ministry of, Bureau of Indian Standard, bis.gov.in. Here, whenever any quality control order is issued, new products is added, they modify that. And we can see the list of products which needs BIS registration here.
Mm-hmm.
And if any audience is having any query, they can raise the query, we can check and confirm whether product requires registration or not.
All right. So these are the websites where they can check, and if it's not completely clear, or if they still want to check, double check, they can reach out to your office. Droop, there's much more to say about BIS. It's a lengthy process. It's also costly, but it's necessary if you still want to export the products to India. I'm afraid we have to round off here, otherwise we are already almost 10 minutes over time.